Hello. I am Jesus lookalike number two today. If you have been worshipping Tim, you are going to burn in hell worshipping false idol. Some of you may be trying to place my accent on me. I'm actually from Mercia. Is there anyone else from Mercia up here?
No.
Snipers looking though with guns. It's very weird. Whenever I go back to Ayrshire, everyone just immediately says where I'm from. Here. I currently study history in Aberdeen because I don't intend getting a job. and along with that, I do something a bit odd. I do a couple languages. I do Swedish. A lot of people are sort of like, why don't you do Swedish? They don't speak English anyway. The thing is, with Swedish, if you say the word smörgås, suddenly every single Swedish person within a 3-mile radius will come running to you, and they'll say, you said sandwiches. Come, I'm your friend forever, I'll show you IKEA. Take this peasant filth, I will show you the real marriage. That sounds awfully like an innuendo, so no, it's not. They're just really obsessed with jam. It's kind of encouraging though, when you're learning a language and people are sort of like reciprocating, they want you to speak it. Which is like the opposite of how I had with French. When I was about a tiny boy doing French in primary school, we went on a school trip to Marseille. And we went around, I was thinking, feeling quite confident about my skills, having studied for 3 weeks. I thought, oh, nice. I'd go into a shop and I'd try and buy something. There were two people talking away to each other. Do you know normal French stuff like Quel temps fait-il? Oui, je tourne la wank. All that sort of stuff. And I was like, je voudrais. Suddenly, time stopped. Time stopped, froze. This man in his hand, a baguette materialized pure French antipathy towards me. Struck me across the face. His compatriot said, no! You will not speak our. You will not speak our language with a fizzy on decadent tongue. Not until you have had sex with a whore. After painting a picture of having sex with a different whore! She learned much at 12. I quite like that joke. My girlfriend at the time wasn't quite so happy with it after she discovered all the arts and crafts supplies under the bed. She found the portrait of Giselle. She said, Giselle, je ne comprends pas. You're twirling! I'm not looking at my notes, I'm actually looking at a treasure map. Stress. Like, we all have had that. You know, it's kind of been getting me down. You know that way where you wake up, you have a shower, you dry yourself, and you go to put deodorant on, but sometimes you might accidentally like, spray yourself in the face. It was like that, but without the. I just sort of like. I probably deserve this. So I was trying to think of how can I combat this? And it came to me. As all great ideas do, when I was totally drunk at New Year's, I was thinking, I'll just describe everything I do really cool. So that night, I did not crawl miserably into bed, awaiting the horror of another fucking day. I leapt into that bed with the fury of Bruce Lee. I kicked that bed's ass. I felt good for a while until I realized I was just in Tesco just like scanning it and saying, the orange juice of Zeus! I was kicked out. One of my friends then suggested, why don't you try doing something with adrenaline? You know, do something exciting. You know, drive a really fast car, jump off a cliff, punch a shark in the tail, I don't know. And I was like, I already have my way of getting adrenaline, friend. What I do, this is how it makes works. What I do is, I walk really quickly by a police station and yell, I know where all the bodies are hidden! You'll never catch me! Works every time. But it didn't quite alleviate the stress. Yes, I don't. And what I did instead, or what my friend suggested I do instead, he said, "Have you thought about trying drugs?" I thought, "I can't do drugs! I'm already really, really weird. I know what you're thinking, miss. You're looking at me thinking, Johnny, no, you look like a fine, upstanding young citizen. Just please, please, please stay away from my family." But the thing is, I know exactly what would happen if I was on drugs. Someone would find me in the bathroom, just with a basin of water, doing this. Someone walking out and just jump, what the fuck? And say, "I'm the moon!" As you can tell, I'm single. I've been trying to come online dating as a recurring theme of many people tonight. But I've tried that, and there's a problem I found is that if you try to build a group profile, you have to include, as a man, I'm 6 foot tall. Which is, I don't get this. There's this weird corollary in one's brains between the number six and the word sex, which doesn't make sense unless you're Swedish, in which case that's just how it works. Which led to a lot of confusion for Stockholm's number one Iron Maiden tribute band, Sex Sex Sex, Nummer Naf Besten. That's just a lot of confused person. Klaus, help me. I was looking for the oldest sex. I found a Satan. No! That's why I feel jump. I don't understand it, because there's a dark secret, despite me always putting I'm 6 foot tall on my all my profiles.
I'm actually 5 foot 11 and a half.
You're fucking Hitler! each time though, I'm still like really scared that it's gonna go really well, but then suddenly she's just gonna whip a tape measure and just look at me and just like, "What else have you been lying to me about, Jean-Pierre?" Should have come from back! I've been Johnny Boyd, enjoy the rest of the